Let's talk about hierarchies and hierarchical data. What? Hierarchies? Who needs that? Literally nobody needs that. So this video is going to be very short.
Literally everybody cares about hierarchical data. For instance, the armies are built on a hierarchy. Nature is one big hierarchy. And companies care about hierarchical data. Supply chain management, people management, bill of materials, financial governance. All of these things are dependent on the ability of the enterprise to analyze their hierarchical data. Heck, even the mafia is a hierarchy.
That was David, my colleague, and he asked me to do this video based on a blog post series I posted on Medium some time ago. You'll find the link in the description box down below. I'm Sasha and we both work for Snowflake. In this video, we'll be showing how companies improve their businesses by analyzing their hierarchical data on Snowflake. And watch this video till the end for bonus content showing how companies can analyze their hierarchical data stored in Snowflake using business intelligence tools such as Tableau. Let's get into it.
March 2021, Suez Canal. Megaship Ever Given ran aground and blocked the passage for all traffic through the canal. For the next 6 days, at least 369 other ships queued up to pass the canal, stranding almost $10 billion in trade. This major supply chain disruption affected everyone. Deliveries of medication, food, spare parts, and everything else were delayed. The cost of doing business went up and insurance claims skyrocketed. Everyone and anyone was impacted. You, me, and the person next door.
And while in the case of Suez Canal it was obvious that it would affect anyone, similar supply chain disruptions happen daily around the world and they affect businesses and people. They just don't make the news. But what can the businesses do to assess and mitigate the risk of such supply chain disruptions? Well, the usual, they have to crunch a bunch of data and make timely conclusions. But this data is complex. It doesn't fit into an Excel sheet as its nature is not rows and columns, but rather it's hierarchical tree-like data. A common example for such data is the hierarchy of cost centers in a company. Big corporations have upwards of 100,000 cost centers that are spread across in a very complex hierarchy, and any one of them can carry costs and or revenue. Let's look at a cost center hierarchy for Acme Inc. Our task is to calculate the sum of all costs incurred by logistics cost centers. To do that, we traverse the tree starting from the logistics cost center and move down. Each time we move down, we check if that cost center has children, i.e. further cost centers under it. If yes, we continue traversing down until we find no more children. In this case, the energy cost center has three children cost center nodes, which in turn have no children of their own. So we'll sum the costs of these three children, electricity, water, and gas, and move up to energy. We'll add the sum of costs of energy and we're finished with this branch. We're not done yet though, as there's another branch, buildings. We'll traverse this branch and sum up everything along. Finally, we're done with all children of logistics, so we'll move up and add the costs of the logistics cost center itself. And now we're done. The process I've just described is called recursion. Snowflake can do recursive queries natively by using the recursive common table expression queries, so-called CTEs. Here's a sample query that does exactly what I described before with our sample data. However, these queries can be complex to write and maintain, even for very simple hierarchies, such as the one in my example. If you want to add more criteria for filtering on cost center, for instance, types or types of costs, or join across other tables, these queries can quickly become unmanageable. Also, these queries can take some time. If you're working with a hierarchy of 100,000 cost centers, it may take 60 seconds to calculate a query. Imagine the financial controller has to wait 60 seconds for every step, every next value calculation. That's going to become boring very quickly. There's a much better way to tackle this. Let's look at our sample hierarchy. The recursion method calculates all unique paths from each leaf up to the head of the hierarchy, a cost center node with no parents. If we pre-calculate all the paths and persist the results, we would not need to do any new recursion afterwards. Instead, we just use the pre-calculated paths to do our calculation, such as finding a sum of all costs along the paths. How do we persist these paths in Snowflake? We could put each member of a path in a separate column, but as the depth of a path, the number of nodes in the path varies, we don't know how many columns we need in a table, so that's not very flexible. Instead, we'll use JSON arrays for that. Each path starts with a head node and ends with a leaf node. Here's the one-time recursion we'd need to run to create this structure. By the way, you'll find all these code samples I'm showing on the screen in the repo, and it's linked down below in the description box. The resulting table with all paths from our hierarchy persisted looks like this. And now our queries are much, much simpler to write and maintain. Here's a query that calculates the sum of all costs for logistics. It has gotten way simpler. And not only it is easier to write and maintain, but it's also much faster to execute. So it saves compute costs, but it also makes the work of a financial controller more efficient. In this video, I've shown how we can efficiently work with hierarchical data in Snowflake, how to persist them in JSON structure so we can write simple and fast queries. But what happens if we want to connect a business intelligence tool to Snowflake to analyze this data? Well, these tools usually need different structures. In the repo that's linked in the description box below, you'll find a link to Snowflake stored procedure that takes our table with materialized paths and transforms the data into a new table that any tool can use to visualize and analyze hierarchies. Let me know in the comments which challenges you encounter when working with hierarchical data, such as the one that I've shown in this video. And also connect with me on LinkedIn, here's my QR code, to continue this conversation there. Stay healthy and stay tuned.